our expert speaker for the final session of the day. I welcome you, sir, to this STTP. So, a brief introduction of Dr. Anil Kumar. I would like to introduce to you all. Dr. Anil Kumar is working as a professor and head mechanical department at Indo Global College of Engineering, New Chandigarh. He has done bachelor's degree from St. Longwell Institute of Engineering and Technology, Punjab, and master's of technology from Guru Nanak Dev Engineering College, Ludhiana. He got doctorate degree from Punjab Technical University, IKG PTU campus, Jalandhar. He has more than 17 years of teaching and 5 years of industrial exposure. He is an active member of Academic Council and coordinator of industrial defined projects and is credited with various innovative projects developed by engineering students under his guidance. His area of expertise is industrial engineering, engineering in energy efficiency, welding metallurgy, and engineering materials. He has authored one book in mechanical engineering. He has presented 22 papers in international and national conferences and published 7 papers in international journals. So we welcome you, sir, to this final session of STTP. And without wasting much more time, I would invite you to please start with the session for the day. So off to you, sir.
Thank you for a nice introduction. So first of all, I like to say thank to principal of IGCE, principal of IGCMT, Dean Academics, and the main coordinator of short term program, and all the staff associated with this short term program. And I welcome all the guests, all the delegates to this program. Now, regarding my presentation, we all know that these days we are facing a very grave problem of solid waste. Indeed, all the big cities, metro cities, they are facing this problem, and not over India, even all across the world. This problem is taking a very big shape. If we talk about the India, this the solid waste management is still at an nascent state, and we don't know how to manage our solid waste in a scientific manner. So today's my topic of presentation is importance of recycling to solid waste management. Now these are the main contents of this presentation. This first we will introduce, I will introduce the what is the type of problem we are facing, then overview of solid waste, recycling concept, scope of recycling, recycling materials, and then few illustrations of recycled materials. Now, as we have already, I have explained you that the solid waste, the managing this our waste is becomes a very big problem for us. Now, due to our increasing living standards and increasing population, and also due to our increasing per capita income, and there are many other factors which add to this waste generation. Waste that we are generating at this moment is much higher than we are generating 10 years back. And the main thing is that the rate at which the nature can process this waste, and the rate at which we are this generating the waste, there becomes a big mismatch between that. At present, we are generating around 72 million tons of solid waste in India. Now, this growing volume of waste are eating up our cities and choking water bodies. Now, the major sources of waste jo originate hota hai, wo hai sabse pehle industrial waste, agricultural waste, solid waste, and then construction and demolition waste, and rest of all the other waste is comes under the miscellaneous waste. This is the overview of solid waste in India. Now, this the big chunk of this waste is consist of solid waste, municipal solid waste. It is around 45% of the total waste generation of India, which is around 72 million tons. Now, the second chunk is agricultural waste. This is 24%, and the third is industrial waste. Now, industrial waste consists of hazardous and non-hazardous waste, and the rest is the miscellaneous waste. Now, and this red chunk, this red portion, this waste consist of municipal solid waste and construction and demolition waste. Now after 2018, the government has separated the C&D waste from the municipal waste. So now these days this waste is analyzed separately, and it is no more the part of municipal solid waste. Now this, if we talk about the municipal solid waste, it consists of all the these main things from which it comes. First is, it is the main sources of this waste is commercial and institutional waste, like this college, then hospitals and all the commercial institutes. Then the waste which is coming from that institutes, they comes under municipal solid waste. Then household waste, all our kitchen waste, all our sweepings and all other waste, it also add to the municipal solid waste. Then treated biomedical waste, then slaughterhouse waste, horticulture waste, and then street sweepings and all the other waste, it also comes in solid this municipal solid waste. Now waste disposal methods. Now these are the various methods through which we can dispose of, or we can process the waste. These are the various techniques. First one is incineration, which is least preferred. Energy recovery is moderately preferred, and recycling is the most preferred method. Then composting is moderately preferred, and landfilling is least preferred method. Now first one is the incineration. Now the controlled burning of waste without pre-processing to reduce the volume. Basically, this technique, in this technique we burn the waste at a very high temperature. For example, the waste which is coming from the hospitals, which is very toxic and which is very infectious, so that waste should be, it should be burned at very high temperature. So incineration helps to reduce the volume of waste, and it can reduce the volume by 96%. But the main drawback of this technique is it also produces many types of gases, and moreover this technique is usually preferred in the countries where there is a problem of space. Now that is why this technique should be employed when we do not have any other option. So most of the smaller countries like Japan and others, they prefer this technique because they have a scarcity of land. Now the second method is energy recovery. Now if the waste substance, if our the waste which is collected, if it consists of a very high calorific value, then we can recover energy from that waste. So there are various methods through which we can recover the energy from waste, like gasification, anaerobic digestion, and refused dried fuels. Now these, the recovered energy can be used for some commercial purpose or some industrial process. So this is this method is somewhat preferred because in this method we can recover the energy and which can be utilized somewhere. So the next method is recycling. Now the recycling is the most preferred method because this is a method which is most effective and which is which generates least amount of polluting gases, and it is also the process which employs a lot of employment, and it can recover a lot of energy. Now the composting is also a part of recycling, and it is a natural process of recycling organic matter into humus. We all know very well about the composting method. Now composting of biodegradables. Now there are many waste which is consist of biodegradable waste. Usually the biodegradable waste consists of plant and animal origin, and it can be decomposed by living organisms. And when it decomposes in the presence of oxygen, it breaks down into simpler compounds and release carbon and water, carbon dioxide and water. So the end product is again compost. So the last, jo, when we do all the processes, jitna bhi usme se hum segregation kar sakte hain, jitna bhi usme se recover kar sakte hain, uske baad jo end state hoti hai jo waste ki, we usually dump that waste in some open spaces so that at last state it can process naturally. So the waste is finally dumped onto an open lands after segregation for further processing. अब उसमें भी कई बार होता है कि फर्दर प्रोसेसिंग में उसमें वेस्ट टू एनर्जी अगर हम रिकवर कर सकते हैं उसमें से, तो हम कर लेते हैं, या इंसिनरेशन, इसको इंसिनरेट कर सकते हैं. लेकिन लैंड फिलिंग इट शुड बी लीस्ट प्रेफर्ड मेथड. नाउ अगर हम देखें यहाँ पे चंडीगढ़ में भी हमारे यहाँ पे जो लैंड फिलिंग हो रही है, इट इज़ आई थिंक इन आपने देखा होगा 38 वेस्ट वाली तरफ जो है सारा जो लैंड है दैट इज़ रिक्वायर्ड फॉर लैंड फिलिंग. अब उसमें अब फ्रॉम इफ यू ऑब्जर्व फ्रॉम लास्ट 10 ईयर्स यू मस्ट हैव ऑब्जर्व दैट द पाइल ऑफ गार्बेज इज गोइंग अप, उसकी जो हाइट है इंक्रीज हो रही है वो. सो इफ़ द हाइट ऑफ गार्बेज इंक्रीजिंग, अगर वॉल्यूम इंक्रीज हो रही है, इट मीन्स द जो हम वेस्ट डिस्पोजल मेथड्स हैं हमारे वो बहुत ही इनफेक्टिव है. सो वी आर नॉट इफेक्टिवली मैनेजिंग दिस वेस्ट, सो दैट इज़ वाई इट इज़ द वॉल्यूम इज इंक्रीजिंग. सो दिस इज़ अगेन अ वेरी अलार्मिंग कंडीशन फॉर अस. नाउ दिस इज़ एन ओवरव्यू ऑफ म्युनिसिपल सॉलिड वेस्ट इन परसेंटेज. नाउ टोटल वेस्ट इज 72 बिलियन टन्स एज पर स्टडी ऑफ आई थिंक 2017. नाउ इट इज़ अ वेरी गुड थिंग दैट इंडियन जो इंडिया के अंदर जो हमारा वेस्ट है उसकी जो मेन जो चंक ऑफ वेस्ट है अबाउट 50% वेस्ट कंप्राइजेज ऑफ बायोडिग्रेडेबल्स, सो दैट कैन बी इजली प्रोसेस्ड. एंड रेस्ट ऑफ दैट चंक इज कंसिस्ट ऑफ अबाउट 32% इज नॉन बायोडिग्रेडेबल विच इज़ कंसिस्ट ऑफ टेक्सटाइल ग्लास एंड ऑल मेटल्स स्लेट स्टील स्वीपिंग एक्सेट्रा. देन 7% इज कंसिस्ट ऑफ पेपर and 10% is of that waste consists of plastic. Similarly, if we compare our this solid waste with USA, because USA is the country which is the most, which is generating the most biggest volume of this solid waste across the world. It is generating about 4 to 6 times more waste than India, but at the same time it is also processing much more than India. So you can observe here that in USA the major chunk consists of paper and paper board, which is 23%, and second largest portion is of food, which is 21.5%, and rest is all glass, metal, plastic, inorganic wastes, then other textiles, rubbers, etc. Now solid waste principle, as per solid waste principle which is usually followed all over, across the world, the principle says that we should reduce the waste. This is the hierarchy of solid waste management. Now as per this this technique, this is the most preferred methods and last one is the most least preferred method. The first one is reduce the waste generation, number two is reuse the waste, number three is recycling of waste, and number four is recovery, and last one is disposal. So first one is reduce. Reduce means we can reduce the waste before it is being converted into waste by reducing unnecessary purchases, by reducing the volume of waste at source, and by reducing the non-biodegradable items. So this is the first method. Second one is reuse. Reuse means we can take care of our old stuff so that we can impart it more life, and we need lesser amount of new products. Second is repurpose the items in a creative way. Repurpose means any discarded material, if we can reuse it for some any other purpose, we can save it from going into the trash. So in this way we can reduce the volume of waste in our bin and dustbin. So repurpose ke andar bahut sare methods hain. There are many creative ways by which we can repurpose our items. And aap sabhi ne dekha bhi hoga ki aajkal jo hai kai market mein kai tarah se kai methods, innovative methods hain jisme hum apne waste ko jo hai reuse kar rahe hain. सिमिलरली री यूज़ ऑफ ग्रोसरी बैग्स मीन्स कि आप जब मार्केट में जाते हैं हम तो उसमें जितना भी हो सके हम कम जो है पॉलीथीन बैग्स या जितना भी उसमें पैकेजिंग मटेरियल है वो वापस लेके आएँ, जिससे कि जो वेस्ट जनरेशन है उसकी वॉल्यूम जो है कम हो सके. नाउ द मेन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग वी वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट वॉज द रीसाइकिलिंग. नाउ रीसाइकिलिंग इन्वॉल्व्स द एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ डिस्कार्डेड मटेरियल फ्रॉम वेस्ट फॉर री यूज. सो बेसिकली रीसाइकिलिंग में हम जो भी वेस्ट के अंदर जो मटेरियल है जो हम रीयूज़ कर सकते हैं उसको हम रिकवर करते हैं, और इसका जो सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट है दैट इज़ रिक्लेमिंग एंड रीयूज ऑफ मटेरियल इन अ न्यू प्रोडक्ट साइकिल. सो बेसिकली रीसाइकिलिंग के अंदर किसी भी जो प्रोडक्ट साइकिल के अंदर हम इसके जो रिक्लेम्ड मटेरियल्स हैं उनको हम रीयूज़ करते हैं, जिससे कि उसके अंदर जो एनर्जी है द टोटल एनर्जी इनटेक वो भी कम होती है, प्लस जो वॉल्यूम ऑफ जो हमारा जो वेस्ट है जो एंड लाइफ साइकिल के एंड में जो पहुँचता है उसकी वॉल्यूम भी जो रिड्यूस हो सकती है. सो इट आल्सो डिफर्स द कंजम्पशन ऑफ वर्जिन रिसोर्सेज. सो फॉर एग्जांपल इफ़ वी रीयूज मेटल्स और इफ़ वी रीयूज ग्लास एंड प्लास्टिक वी कैन डिफर द नीड ऑफ वर्जिन रिसोर्सेज लाइक वी नीड लेसर अमाउंट ऑफ ओर ऑफ आयरन ओर वी नीड लेसर अमाउंट ऑफ अदर दिस कंपाउंड्स if we reuse the material. Similarly, it also helps to mitigate the greenhouse effect. It also reduces the waste disposal at the end of the life cycle. Now, if we compare our municipal solid waste recycling and other stats, India versus USA. Now, you will observe that the total waste generation of India is 72 million tons. As against the USA, which is 292 million tons, and the collection rate of India is only 42%, 42 million tons. It comes around, I think, 60 to 65%, and collection rate of USA is around 280. And treatment of solid waste, जिसको हम कहते हैं recycling or any other treatment जो भी मिल रही है. Now India की जो recycling या treatment है, it is very very less. Only 3.2 million, which comes around 6%, I think, and USA is quite high. Although USA is producing very high amount of waste, but it is also processing it very effectively. And what if how you will say that scenario kis tarah hoga agar hum recycle nahi karte, what will happen if we do not recycle? So if we do not recycle, we will definitely going to see all these problems in near future. All our open spaces, they will litter with the this solid waste. The garbage will goes on piling up each and every day, as we can also see in our cities. And also all the this waste will it is a breeding ground of many types of flies, rodents and other diseases. It will also choke our water bodies. It will also choke the groundwater and other this resources of water. And it will choke all the open spaces, green areas. So that is why recycling and processing of waste is very important. Now, what is the importance of recycling? Now the main benefits of recycling is, first, it helps to reduce the waste. Second, it mitigates the pollution, and it also reduces the need to harvest new materials. It also saves energy and also reduce the greenhouse gas emissions, and at the end it also helps to create very many jobs in while we start doing recycling. Now recycling waste of non-biodegradables. Now it involves the recovering and reprocessing usable materials that otherwise end up as a waste. So basically, non-biodegradable materials are we cannot process these waste by natural process. So either we have to reprocess or recover these materials from the non-biodegradables and reuse them in some other cycle. Now, recovered material is transformed into useful products that can largely reduce the demand for additional resources. Now, for example, recycled aluminium sheets can be made with 95% less power than virgin aluminium. Now, as I already told that if we recycle and we reuse the aluminium cans, like, it can reduce energy input in the manufacturing process by 92%. So this is a very big amount of energy that we can save. It also give many other benefits. Similarly, reusing of and recycling of glass bottles and glass items, it can help to reduce energy by 44% in manufacturing of glass. And similarly, by reusing plastic, we can save up to 70% of energy in manufacturing new articles. Similarly, the recycling also open avenues for very large number of this different types of jobs. For example, landfilling, अगर हम dump करते हैं सीधा landfilling में, तो उसमें जो है बहुत कम jobs हैं. अगर recycling करते हैं, it gives up to 10 times more jobs. But if we start manufacturing based on recycled materials, then we can go further. We can give much more jobs than as compared to recycling processing. So the most recyclable materials जो हैं हमारे जो जो कि ईजिली हम रिसाइकिल कर सकते हैं, उनमें से है कॉन्क्रीट, एल्यूमिनियम शीट्स, स्टील, प्लास्टिक, न्यूज़ पेपर्स, देन कॉरूगेटेड कार्डबोर्ड्स एंड HDPE प्लास्टिक एंड ग्लास. सो रिसाइकिलिंग एंड यूटिलाइजेशन, अब बेसिकली रिसाइकिल मटेरियल्स जो हैं कहाँ कहाँ पे हम उसको यूज़ कर सकते हैं. नाउ फर्स्ट जैसे एग्जांपल है एग्रो वेस्ट जो है, जितना भी है उसको जो उसके सोर्स हैं, जैसे राइस हस्क होगी, बैगेज हो गया, व्हीट स्ट्रॉ हस्क, ऑल दिस वेस्ट दे कैन बी रिसाइकल एंड रीयूज फॉर बिल्डिंग मटेरियल्स, फॉर मेकिंग ऑफ प्लास्टिक बोर्ड्स, इंसुलेशन बोर्ड्स, वॉल पैनल्स, प्रिंटिंग पेपर्स, कॉरूगेटिंग मीडियम, रूफिंग शीट्स, फ्यूल बाइंडर्स एंड मैनी अदर थिंग्स. सिमिलरली इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट जो है, जो ऑर्गेनिक वेस्ट है, दैट कैन बी द सोर्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक वेस्ट इज कोल, कंबस्टन रेजिड्यू, स्टील स्लैग, बॉक्साइट, रेड मड एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन डेब्रीज. फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन रिकवर एंड रिसाइकिल, वी कैन रीयूज इट इन एज अ सीमेंट, ब्रिक, ब्रॉक्स, टाइल्स, पेंट्स, एग्रीगेट्स, कंक्रीट्स, वुड्स एंड मैनी अदर आर्टिकल्स. सिमिलरली माइनिंग एंड मिनरल वेस्ट के इस तरह से हम यूज़ कर सकते हैं टू मेक ब्रिक्स, टाइल्स एंड लाइट वेट एग्रीगेट्स. देन नॉन हैजर्डस वेस्ट के अंदर वेस्ट जिप्सम, लाइम स्लज, लाइम स्टोन वेस्ट, मार्बल्स, ऑल दिस इट कैन बी यूज टू मेक जिप्सम प्लास्टर, फाइबरस जिप्सम बोर्ड्स, ब्रिक ब्लॉक, सीमेंट क्लिंकर्स एंड हाइड्रोलिक बाइंडर्स. एंड देर इज़ अ वेस्ट विच इज़ हैजर्डस वेस्ट, इट कैन बी यूज. एंड दिस इज़ अ स्टडी हिटिंग अराउंड 7,000 million टन्स एंड रीप्रोसेसिंग कैपेसिटी इज़ 4,150 million टन्स, विच इज़ आई थिंक अराउंड 60%, एंड द फाइन इज़ 5,000. सो हेयर यू कैन गेट एन ओवरव्यू दैट हाउ मच ग्रेव सिचुएशन इज रिगार्डिंग कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड डिमोलिशन वेस्ट. नाउ दिस वेस्ट कैन ऑल्सो बी यूटिलाइज इन मैनी वेज, लाइक इट कैन 13% ऑफ दिस वेस्ट कैन बी यूज एज अ स्ट्रक्चरल फिल, सॉयल स्टेबिलाइजर्स एंड रोड एम्बागमेंट वर्क. 12% ऑफ दिस कैन बी यूज फॉर दिस पार्टिकल बोर्ड्स, पैनल्स, कंपोजिट वुड्स. एंड 11% ऑफ दिस वेस्ट कैन बी यूज एज अ सिरेमिक प्रोडक्ट्स. देन द रेस्ट ऑफ 11% कैन बी यूज एज अ सीमेंट इन्ग्रीडियंट्स. देन 12% कैन बी यूज एज इन ब्रिक एंड ब्लॉक टाइल्स, कंक्रीट रूफिंग 7%, एग्रीगेट्स, पेंट्स. सो इन दिस वे वी कैन ईजिली रिकवर एंड रीयूज द कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड डिमोलिशन वेस्ट. सो एम आई ऑडिबल? एंड ओके. सो वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट द कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड डिमोलिशन वेस्ट. नाउ द मेन दिस मटीरियल दैट कैन बी रिकवर्ड फ्रॉम CND वेस्ट इज कंक्रीट, एसफाल्ट, प्लास्टिक, एल्यूमिनियम, स्टील एंड ग्लास. नाउ रीसाइकल कंक्रीट, इट कैन बी यूज एज अ परमेबल पेविंग वेज फॉर वॉकवेज, देन बेस फॉर न्यू एसफाल्ट पेविंग्स. नाउ दीज आर द वेरियस टाइल्स. देन एज अ फाउंडेशन मटीरियल्स एंड एज एन एग्रीगेट मटीरियल फॉर न्यू कंक्रीट. सो रीसाइकल कंक्रीट हैज़ अ मैनी यूज एंड इट कैन बी ईजली दिस यूटिलाइज एट मैनी प्लेसेस. सिमिलरली रिक्लेम्ड एसफाल्ट इज द मटीरियल विच इज रिक्लेम्ड फ्रॉम द नोन एज RAP. RAP इज रिप्ड एसफाल्ट मटीरियल विच इज रिप्ड फ्रॉम द दिस ओल्ड दिस रोड. नाउ द रिक्लेम्ड एसफाल्ट पेमेंट इज गिवन टू रिप्ड एंड रीप्रोसेस पेमेंट मटीरियल्स कंटेनिंग एसफाल्ट एंड एग्रीगेट्स. नाउ दिस asphalt pavement is removed by milling of full depth removal process. So about 90 million tons of asphalt payments are reclaimed each year. That is 80% reclaiming efficiency. Now this phenomenon is not in India, but it is, I think, in European countries they have started reclaiming asphalt. But in India we are also dumping this, and we are never did this recovering method. We have not started yet. Similarly, recycled steel, then scrap metal can yield energy savings up to 76%. So steel can be infinitely recycled with 100% recyclability without loss of quality. So building materials, the main items that can be manufactured from recycled steel is building materials, utility poles, industrial tanks, household appliances, and many other items like this bicycle parts, many this automobile parts, steel beams, rebars, and other many articles that can be manufactured from reclaimed steel. Similarly, recycled plastic. Now, recycled plastic, we know that the big part of our waste is these days is plastic items, because it takes a lot of time to decompose. So it is better to recycle or recover the plastic and recycle it, and then manufacture new products out of it. Now, recycled plastic packaging, it is a very new trend, and it helps to mitigate the pollution, and also it saves water and reduce the volume of garbage going into the landfill. Now, polyethylene tetraphthalate is the most used recycled material in rigid plastic packings. These days, many packings materials comprises of this PET material, and this material is used for making soft drinks, water bottles, and this also it is the benefit of PET is that it is very robust and it is also very lightweight. Now, out of 0.9 million tons of PET produced, India is producing about 1 million tons of PET products, which is with 90% recycling efficiency. So this makes India one of the world leader in recycling of PET items. Now these are the PET items products like synthetic clothing, which is these days these are very much used in sports wears. Similarly, these are the playways for children's, many sweeping items, household items, they are made from PET products. Then many other things also they are produced from the PET products. Now, recycled aluminium. Now we know that aluminium cans, they are aluminium cans and frames are recycled by this method by sorting, melting in ingots of aluminium. And aluminium cans jo hai iska recycling agar dekhen, so these days aluminium cans there are you have seen a lot of volume of this aluminium cans, and the process starts with the collection of this cans, aluminium items, then shredding this items, and then compressing it into very dense this space, then again re-shredding into to a smaller pieces. Then these all these pieces, they are all the paint and other coatings are removed from these pieces, then they are remelted and then converted into ingots. The ingots are cold rolled or hot rolled into a thin sheets, and this sheet rolls are then again reused for manufacture of aluminium cans. So in this way we can go for a closed loop manufacturing system, which is a very important part of recycling of solid waste. Similarly, glass can also be recovered and reused very efficiently without loss of any quality. So it is also the same process is followed here also. First of all, this sorting of glass, then sorting is then recycling, and this collected at some place. Then they are sorted by their different materials, their by color and size. Then again they are remelted and then rebuilt with the new products, and then again they are sent to the market. So this is again a closed loop manufacturing system in case of glass. Now recycling of paper. Now paper is can also be recycled and reused at many places, at many applications, and especially in India, the paper industry, the recycled paper industry is a very big market in India. Now recycled paper items in India, they are in the form of newspapers, cardboards, boxes, and various types of packaging. And the recycling industry needs about 14 million tons of waste paper to meet the current demand. But whereas our domestic recycling produces only 30% of that amount, so rest of that recycling and this gap, we have this, we fulfill it by importing the recycled paper from the European countries. So in this way, India is a very big market for the recycled paper. Now these are the this products manufactured out of recycled materials like egg cartons, building insulations, construction paper, then paper boards and all these things, newspapers, counter boards and paper plates. All these items are this manufactured from the recycled paper. Now there are many companies which are selling only recycled products, and they produce all the they manufacture these products by using only recycled materials. So among these companies, one is Elbird, which is known very known for making footwear from 100% recycled materials. Similarly, a company Loopwork, it sells only it manufacture bags which is made from recycled material only, and this company is doing this manufacturing. This manufacturing is based on closed loop system, which we have just seen in our last slide. Then there is a Green Toys. It also manufactures children toys using recycled materials only. Then Tetra Cycle, this company collects and virtually any type of discarded materials, non-biodegradable materials, and then sell it to other companies. It sort the this items, sort the materials, and then it sent to the companies as per their needs. So it is also helping this environment. Now in India, there are many types of barriers which and facilities. So basically in India, we have not just started this recycling of various materials in a scientific manner, and moreover there is absence of appropriate technology and lack of awareness, and there is also poor source separation practice. This practice basically segregation jo hai, it is very very important. Or segregation jo hamara waste hai, अगर जब तक वेस्ट को हम सेग्रीगेट नहीं करेंगे, हम उसको रीसाइकलिंग करना उसके लिए बहुत ही जो है मुश्किल है. सो वेस्ट सेग्रीगेशन जो टेक्निक है, इट इज़ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, एंड द की टू एफिशिएंट वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट इज़ टू सेग्रीगेट एट सोर्स. सो बेसिकली जो सेग्रीगेशन प्रोसेस है, वो स्टार्ट कहाँ से होता है, जहाँ पर वेस्ट जो सोर्स है, जहाँ पर वेस्ट जो है ओरिजिनेट होता है, अगर वहीं पर हम उसको सेग्रीगेट करते हैं, then it is very easy to reuse or recover the materials. लेकिन अगर एक बार वेस्ट जो है मिक्स हो गया, तो उसको सेग्रीगेट करना बड़ा मुश्किल है. सो वंस सेग्रीगेट दिस सेग्रीगेशन इज मेक्स इट ईजियर टू अप्लाई डिफरेंट रिकवरी मेथड्स लाइक कंपोस्टिंग, रिसाइकलिंग एंड इंसिनरेशन. सो देयरफॉर इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू प्रैक्टिस द वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट एंड सेग्रीगेट एज अ कम्युनिटी. नाउ अभी जो है सेग्रीगेशन प्रैक्टिसेस अभी सभी सिटीज़ में अभी स्टार्ट नहीं हुए हैं, लेकिन फिर भी कई जगह पे जो है देयर वेस्ट सेग्रीगेशन जो सिस्टम है वो जो है स्टार्ट हुआ है, और कई जगह पे काफ़ी इफेक्टिवली काम भी कर रहे हैं. सो बेसिकली हम इसको कई तरह से सेग्रीगेट कर सकते हैं, जैसे वी कैन सेग्रीगेट द अवर वेस्ट लाइक पेपर, ग्लास, प्लास्टिक एंड मेटल्स इन सेपरेट बिन्स. सो एट लास्ट the things can change even faster if we can imbibe the habit of waste segregation at homes and stop dumping mixed waste. And handling the non-biodegradable waste carefully, especially poly bags, plastics, bottles, chips and other packaging at remote places or isolated places. सो बेसिकली सबसे पहले तो जो हमारी जो आवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इज़ टू सेग्रीगेट द वेस्ट, हम अपने लेवल पे भी कर सकते हैं इसको कि घर में जो हमारा किचन वेस्ट है, जो बायोडिग्रेडेबल वेस्ट है, उसको हम नॉन बायोडिग्रेडेबल वेस्ट के साथ मिक्स ना करें. अगर हम चाहते हैं वी कैन आल्सो स्टार्ट दिस प्रैक्टिस एट होम आल्सो बाय सेपरेटिंग ऑल द प्लास्टिक एंड ऑल द मेटल पार्ट्स एंड स्टोरिंग इट सम एट दिस सम इन सम कंटेनर्स और बैग्स एंड थ्रोइंग ओनली द बायो वेस्ट इन द डस्टबिन. सिमिलरली हम जब हम घूमने जाते हैं कहीं पे, या व्हेन वी गो सम दिस हिमाचल प्रदेश या कहीं इसी जगह पे आइसोलेटेड प्लेस पे जाते हैं, अगर वहाँ पे हम वी यूजली टेक अवे प्लास्टिक बॉटल्स, वाटर बॉटल्स, देन चिप्स एंड अदर जो हम पैकेजिंग मटेरियल लेके जाते हैं, तो उस जगह पे अगर हम उस चीज़ को डंप करते हैं तो वहाँ पे ऐसी जगह पे वो जो चीज़ें हैं एक बार अंदर तो जाती हैं लेकिन बाहर आना बड़ा मुश्किल है, बिकॉज देयर इज़ नो सिस्टम टू कलेक्ट दिस वेस्ट और टू रिकवर ऑल दिस वेस्ट. सो इट इज़ अवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू नेवर लिटर द वेस्ट एट दीज सच प्लेसेस. सो बेसिकली देयर इज़ नो वेस्ट जनरेशन इन नेचर एंड नेचर्स डिज़ाइन इज़ फ्लॉलेस. नाउ इट्स टाइम वी मस्ट लर्न फ्रॉम द नेचर एंड रीमॉडल अवर मेथड्स एंड टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर द सस्टेन डेवलपमेंट. सो विद दिस आई फिनिश माई दिस प्रेजेंटेशन. थैंक यू टू एवरी वन.